Hello friends, let us now learn some important points about oxygen therapy. So first, in the oxygen therapy, what does the oxygen delivery depend upon? Oxygen delivery in tissues will depend on number one, oxygen content, that is hemoglobin, based on hemoglobin and saturation of oxygen, and it is depend upon cardiac output and also perfusion of the tissues. Then if you see what is oxygen saturation depends on, this oxygen saturation is dependent on partial pressure of oxygen. This partial pressure of oxygen target partial pressure of oxygen to prevent tissue hypoxia. Target partial pressure of oxygen to prevent tissue hypoxia is in adults. It is more than 60 millimeters of Hg, and in infants it is more than 50 millimeters of Hg. Now if you see, why do you do oxygen therapy? Oxygen therapy is to treat hypoxemia. And what is oxygen? Oxygen is actually a drug. So let us now learn some important points about oxygen delivery mechanisms, oxygen delivery devices. Oxygen delivery devices can be divided into two types. One, we have variable performance devices, variable performance or low flow devices. Second, we have fixed performance devices or high flow devices. Variable performance or low flow devices, fixed performance or high flow devices. So what are the uses? Why do you need oxygen delivery devices? This oxygen delivery devices are necessary to administer oxygen, then to regulate oxygen given, and then to supplement oxygen, to regulate the oxygen given, and we should also supplement oxygen to the patient. For these, oxygen devices are useful. It's same, the amount of oxygen should be given should always be taken care of. Okay, now we will learn about variable performance or low flow devices. So first, if you see variable performance or low flow devices, as the name says, they cannot deliver constant fraction of inspiratory oxygen concentration. Here FiO2 mainly depend on tidal volume, respiratory rate, and the pattern of breathing of the patient. So FiO2 depends upon the tidal volume, respiratory rate, and pattern of breathing of the patient. Then this will mainly contribute to flow rate. So these variable performance devices are mainly important in flow rates. They will just contribute to flow rate. They cannot supplement total flow rate. they won't give total fluoride. They are just used to give some fluoride or some push to the patient. Okay. Now, what are the examples of these low flow devices? So, what is the example? Low flow devices is nasal cannula. Or Hudson's mask, nasal cannula, Hudson's mask or oxygen mask. Then we have oxygen mask with reservoir. All these are the low flow devices. In the oxygen mask with reservoir, we have two. One, we have non-rebreathing oxygen mask reservoir. Second, we have rebreathing oxygen mask reservoir. One, non-rebreathing oxygen mask reservoir. And second, we have rebreathing oxygen mask reservoir. So, all these are the important points about variable performance or low flow rate devices. Now, if you see high flow rate devices, high flow device or fixed performance device, high flow device or fixed performance device, if you see high flow device or fixed performance device, here this will give a constant fractional inspiration of oxygen is delivered. Constant fractional inspiration of oxygen is delivered. It will give high flow rate. It is used to adequately supplement to the flow rate, to the required flow. It can give the required flow. If the patient need high flow rate, then these high flow devices will give the required flow to the patient. So now, what are the examples of this high flow rate? Examples of high flow rate are Venturi mask. Then we have oxygen blenders with nebulizers. Venturi mask, oxygen blenders with nebulizers. And also high flow nasal cannula. High flow nasal cannula. So these are high flow devices. So if you see, what does the choice of delivery system depends on? We have low flow devices and high flow devices. When do you have to choose and what do you have to choose? Based on what? So, choice of delivery system is mainly based on three things. One, it is based on degree of hypoxemia, and it is based on requirement of precision of delivery. Degree of hypoxemia, requirement of precision of delivery, and it is also depend upon the patient comfort and cost. Okay, so choice of delivery system is based on degree of hypoxemia, requirement of precision of surgery, patient comfort and cost. So first we will learn about the nasal cannula. So first, if you see, we have nasal cannula. So what does nasal cannula contain? Nasal cannula mainly consists of two soft prongs, and these two soft prongs are actually attached with oxygen supply. It contains two soft prongs attached with oxygen supply. FiO2 is 20% oxygen with 4 into oxygen liter flow. FiO2 is 20% plus flow into oxygen liter flow. So how much flow rate does the nasal cannula give? It gives around 2 to 6 liters per minute of oxygen flow can be kept. And then how much that does it give? And then if you see, if FiO2 of nasal cannula is put to be 2 liters, okay, so FiO2 20 plus 4 into, if what is the FiO2 of nasal cannula if oxygen flow is equal to 2 liters? If oxygen flow is equal to 2 liters, FiO2 is 20 plus 4 into 2, that is equal to 20 plus 8, 28%. Similarly, if FiO2 of nasal cannula, if oxygen flow is equal to 6 liters, then if you calculate, FiO2 is equal to same formula 4 into 6. 20 plus 4 into 6 that is equal to 20 plus 24 that is 44%. So what is the range of FiO2? Range of FiO2 is equal to 28 to 44% or 0.28 to 0.45. Okay, you should remember these values. This is one thing which you have to remember. Then how much is the oxygen flow and the range. Even if you do not know the calculation, that doesn't matter. Then, now what are the advantages of nasal cannula? If you see the advantages of nasal cannula is simple. It is lightweight, simple, lightweight and comfortable. Because it is simple, lightweight and comfortable, patient can sleep, speak with the nasal cannula. The patient can speak and can eat, and he has long term, he can be put on long term oxygen therapy. For long term oxygen therapy, it is useful. Now, what are the disadvantages? So, if you see the disadvantages, one disadvantage is it cannot provide high flow oxygen. It cannot provide high flow oxygen. It can cause crusting and it can cause dryness of the mucous membranes. It can cause crusting and dryness of nasal mucosa. And one more important thing, if you see, FiO2 is variable. Here FiO2 is variable, right? So it is in the range, it is in the range of almost 0.28 to 0.45. okay, so this is about the nasal cannula. Thank you for watching.